Usually I have a chair in my room and I'm able to have all my tape available so I don't have to worry about where my foam and my tape is. Now I'm going to use an 8 centimeter. I'm bandaging half a leg while the patient is laying down and then I stand them up. So this way it's a lot easier and then I have her stand. And again, this should have been just a little bit. Okay, good. One, and really mold it, firm it. Two, three. Come on, right over the bend of the ankle, low on the Achilles. Come on down, right to the top here of the first toe. Come up again. I'm gonna catch the heel. In the book, it shows the second bandage. You could do it with the first if you wish, depending how swollen the foot is. And come around and catch that top of that heel. My window is there. This is why I like the double length bandage. Yeah, this is not double. That's why I say I like it, because then I'm able to go up higher. Not all, only the 10 centimeter does. And the 12. Okay, depending, now I could actually let her stand if it makes it easier right now because this part of her leg is short. I could go on up and catch here, but I want to continue to bandage, so go ahead and stand up now. And then that helps me. One of the things I've learned through years of doing this, don't go further, because otherwise you take it all off. So how does that feel?
That feels really comfortable.
It feels comfortable. So now I'm secure. As long as her foot's comfortable, the rest is a piece of cake. It's a piece of cake, believe me. This is the most critical part. So if you keep bandaging without asking how that is when she's actually walking and moving, then after you're gonna have to undo that.
That's very comfortable.
Okay, so now I'm going to continue on.